It's a legendary cathedral to speed.
You are fast on the Nordschleife. You are fast everywhere.
Originally built to save a region.
We wanted to boost the economy by building a racetrack.
Known as the Green Hell, its hallowed asphalt has been forged in heartache.
It was a very dangerous track. We had a lot of accidents.
For nearly 100 years, the Nürburgring Nordschleife has been the epicenter of the automotive world.
The Nordschleife is the most challenging, most dangerous, most enjoyable driving racetrack in the world.
Today, it's a key laboratory for four-wheeled machines.
This is the most daunting corner.
The Nürburgring is the ultimate test for a super sports car.
It's proof of the pudding if what they did on the test bench and in the calculation really works.
The best place for a new challenger to make its mark.
We are really busy right now developing our first high-performance car on the Nürburgring.
Both man and machine must prove their mettle by pushing new technologies to the absolute limit inside the ring. Deep in western Germany, carved directly into the Eifel Mountains, stands a wonder of the automotive world.
The Nordschleife is famous for being the most challenging racetrack in the world.
The Nürburgring Nordschleife, it's a famed racetrack, a cultural phenomenon, and a hotbed for automotive testing.
The Nürburgring became a kind of mecca where you have to go one time in your life.
The circuit's main attraction is its unparalleled length.
The secret of the Nürburgring is the long lap.
At 20.8 kilometers, the Nürburgring Nordschleife is the longest racetrack in the world.
Racetracks normally are between 3 to 6 kilometers. What makes the Nürburgring really special is it's really, really long for a racetrack.
The dramatic distance isn't the only attraction. The circuit also features over 300 meters of elevation changes and 73 corners.
On a normal racetrack, you need 10 laps and then you know it pretty well. At the Nürburgring, you need hundreds of laps and you're still learning every lap.
No two turns are alike. Each offers a brand new experience for a driver.
You have lots of different corners. You have ups and downs. You have strange corners.
You can't see into the bends. You're driving right through the middle of a forest. It's really challenging.
Speed and then you have really tight corners following the fast one, but you can't see it, so they are all blind. And then there are the points where the people usually crash very often.
The difficulty is compounded by inclement weather. On average, it rains 223 days a year.
Everything is blind. There is no safety, no runoff. So in the wet, it really gets very, very dangerous. It's a dangerous place, and that's what attracts people.
The extreme length and severe conditions make the circuit a stimulating driving experience and one of the most challenging testing environments in the world.
They go testing here, prototypes. Everything which will be good on the market has to be tested here.
Today, the ring is world-renowned as the ultimate automotive laboratory.
Driving for a couple of thousand kilometers with a new car, you definitely get an idea if the new technology is working well or not.
Nearly every major car company has set up shop here in order to push their newest machines to the absolute edge of performance.
The pinnacle of testing is the Nürburgring because it's the most difficult, the longest, and the most exciting racetrack there is.
The track is a critical location for automotive innovation. A myriad of technological advancements have come to life on this hallowed tarmac.
Every day when there's no race, the track is used by companies and suppliers for their endurance tests. That's still the ultimate proof for a new technology.
Everything from engine tech and suspension setup to ultra-powerful braking advancements are taken to the extreme. Repeatedly analyzed, pushed again and again, only to then be perfected.
In the automotive world, you have benchmarks. And if you produce a car for your customer, you want to produce it at the highest level.
The car has to work a lot here on a notch life. It's always the best thing to test here because 1 kilometer is 1,000 kilometers on a normal track. It's very hard stuff for the car. So the suspension and the tires and brakes, it's 1,000 times harder than on a normal road.
Throughout the decades, the hard work pays off for a variety of automakers.
Every single AMG which you can buy today is developed on an Nordschleife.
For Porsche, it's very important because it's the ultimate test for your car.
It's always good for the car factory when they can say, we tested this car on the Nordschleife. Then everybody says, wow.
The circuit offers the ability to transform dreams into high-performance realities.
If you can make it there, you can make it everywhere, because it's really the hardest track I know worldwide.
The latest company to join the fray is Hyundai. Over a decade ago, they were considered an automotive upstart. Now, they're the fifth largest car maker in the world.
So far, it is not possible to say Hyundai Motors is a premium brand.
Though Hyundai Motor Company has been acknowledged for its proud quality and design innovation, it has been lacking in emphasizing the kind of pleasure of driving that gains passionate fans of the brand.
To gain more fans, a group of dedicated engineers pushed the pedal to the metal.
There might have been many reasons why Hyundai couldn't become a premium brand. And one of them is that our car cannot show the ultimate best performance.
To take the next high-performance step, the brand sets its sights on the famed Nürburgring.
We established a workshop at the Nürburgring and have since continued to test cars in development.
The quest for speed doesn't start in a boardroom.
Its origin comes from the recruitment of those who wanted to make a high-performance car and all voluntarily got together. These people fundamentally love high-performance cars, and it was their dream to create them. Therefore, they are holding their passion in order to make their dream come true.
That passion leads to a new high-performance sub-brand called the N-Division.
Well, I dare say that brand N were changing the future of Hyundai Motors.
Changing a car maker's trajectory is hard to do. However, for nearly 100 years, the Nürburgring Nordschleife has played a key role in altering the future of the automobile as we know it. Yet amazingly, it was almost never built. For nearly a century, the Nürburgring has echoed with the sound of engines. Yet its beginnings are only partly due to the automobile.
The Nürburgring Nordschleife is part of German history. It reaches far back to the beginning of the 20th century, and the automobile was rising in Europe.
In the early part of the century, William II, the Emperor of Germany, is enthusiastic about the racing industry in his country. But the plans are put on hold when World War I breaks out.
In the early 20s, they again started discussing the race and test track for the rising German automobile industry.
The primary rationale isn't motor vehicles, but farmers.
The Eifel was a very poor area. Even the farmland was very bad, so the people were suffering a lot.
So it was really the best idea to build a racetrack here in the region.
In 1925, construction begins. It's an enormously ambitious project that requires over 25,000 workers.
They didn't look at where it was the easiest to go, it's the opposite. They made it a real challenge.
It takes 2 years to complete and costs more than 14 million Reichsmarks. That's the equivalent to over 35 million euros.
From the very beginning on, the Nürburgring was planned as a test track for the German automobile industry.
It might be hard to imagine, but in the 20s, the German auto industry is full of upstarts.
There were many new brands coming up.
Finally, on June the 18th, 1927, the Nürburgring is ready.
The first important race was won by Rudi Caracciola, who was a racer for Mercedes-Benz.
Over the next 10 years, the Germans dominate Grand Prix racing. In the process, they cement a reputation for reliable, high-performance machines. Nearly 100 years later, little has changed at the ring. Modern upstarts still come to the Nordschleife to make a name for themselves.
Hyundai is one of the automotive players who saw that it is absolutely important to get here because it is the hardest test you can do in the world.
In 2013, the brand spends over 6.5 million euros to build a state-of-the-art facility.
When we get a new car, this is the most important time. Overall, the feeling is like on Christmas when you have a new toy unpacked and then you're ready to go, but you have to be very careful. Prototype is a very expensive toy.
The team hides the new prototype in plain sight by applying camouflage. However, changing the appearance of a machine is nothing new at the Nürburgring. In 1934, Mercedes arrives at the ring for a race, but fails inspection.
When they came to the Nürburgring, that car was a few kilograms above the 750 kilogram limit.
That evening, the team has an idea that will alter the brand's destiny one chip of paint at a time.
They had the brilliant idea to scrap the paint off. And the car came under the 750 kilogram weight limit.
Mercedes races and wins, thus giving birth to the legend of the Silver Arrow. From this point forward, all of their race cars will be painted silver.
It sounds romantic, it is romantic, yeah, but that's how life is at the end and how history is, if you look back.
It's a powerful tale that is reinforced in 2013 when a Silver Arrow sells for over 22 million euros at auction. Today, success at the ring isn't nearly as elite. New challenges emerge every year in every category.
We are not developing a car that is available only to an exclusive few. We are starting with the development of a high-performance C-segment car, for it holds the highest demand in the global market.
The C-segment, or compact segment, is one of the most fiercely contested automotive genres, making it the perfect vehicle to prove on the ring. For nearly a century, the Nürburgring Nordschleife has been a key location for worldwide automotive advancement.
The track originally was built as a test track. So it is in the DNA of the Nürburgring.
It's really normal that you see cars like Porsche and Lamborghini and McLaren and a lot of Ferraris, etc.
Exotic cars aren't the only visitors to frequent the ring. Over the years, nearly every major auto manufacturer has used the circuit to develop their cars. Today, over 40 brands use the venue as a critical testing tool. However, before a new machine can hit the track, first it needs to be proven in a lab. For one of the ring's newcomers, that process begins at the Namyang Research and Development Center in Korea, where the search for speed starts very delicately. Scientists use powerful microscopes to find the best material for a new engine.
It can magnify the images of samples more than 600,000 times and can identify the positions of atoms.
At a focused ion beam workstation, researchers create 100 nanometer thick samples of the metal. The microscope is so exact that it can see 1/10,000th of a human hair. Once the team approves a metal, a new engine block is cast. To ensure there are no imperfections, the team checks each prototype block in an advanced CT scan machine.
You can use CT scanning to look through the inside of products without cutting the product concern.
The machine is 100 times more powerful than a traditional CT scan machine in a hospital. And it is accurate to within 10 micrometers, roughly the size of a single red blood cell. They look for defects, including bubbles, foreign objects, and tiny cracks.
Defects even smaller than the size of an invisible hair can cause a big problem. We detect them beforehand and draw out a solution for improvement so that we can prevent the same problem from happening in the manufacturing process.
While engineers study defects, in another area of the facility, the team designs a new engine.
When we decided to initiate the development of high-performance engines, the first, the most important thing was that we had to analyze our existing ordinary engines to identify their weaknesses.
The team discovers two major differences. In a normal engine, pistons spin between 4,000 and 6,000 revolutions per minute. But high-performance engines need to spin faster, often up to 9,000 RPM.
We have never developed the high RPM engines before.
The second modification is not the engine, but how to lubricate it.
Unlike users of ordinary cars, the drivers of high-performance cars can cut corners very sharply. Therefore, the coolant or engine oil can be jerked away to one side, which can cool the engine inconsistently, or in the worst-case scenario, leads to engine issues such as engine failures.
With the key areas identified, the team designs their first true high-performance engine. They begin with a durability valve test that simulates hundreds of thousands of openings. Once the valves are proven, the team turns to a sophisticated engine test bench.
At the moment, our laboratory is testing performance improvements for high-performance engine.
The engine runs at maximum power for over 300,000 kilometers. That's enough energy to power an average house for over 7 years. Each revolution offers clues to tame the ring. Finally, they're ready to build an engine. course, building engines to tame the Nordschleifer isn't actually new.
Four of the world's best racing drivers get off to a roaring start in the German Grand Prix.
In the early 50s, the Nürburgring becomes part of a burgeoning racing series called Formula One.
In 1951, there was the first Formula One race on the Nürburgring, and from then on, Formula One and the Nürburgring became a kind of synonym.
Formula One pushes the edge of automotive technology. Over the years, F1 cars get faster and faster.
Jackie Stewart gave the name Green Hell. When he gave this nickname to the track, there were no runoff areas. You just passed small trees, and with 200 kilometers per hour, even more, you know, it's just like a green tunnel.
The nickname sticks due to the danger. During a 15-year period from 1954 to 1969, five F1 drivers lose their lives, making the Nordschleifer the second most deadly circuit in F1 history.
Formula One cars were too fast for the Nürburgring.
Then in 1976, the ring is rocked when Ferrari driver Niki Lauda has a horrific crash.
It was the end of the Formula One time on the Nordschleifer.
The Nürburgring has just lost its prize place in Formula One. Little does anyone know, the next big thing is just around one of the 73 bends. For over a century, the Nürburgring Nordschleifer challenges drivers and captivates fans. However, by the mid-70s, the circuit hits the wall. The very cars that made it famous are now too fast for it.
I think it was time to stop racing with such fast cars on the Nürburgring.
Suddenly, the ring goes quiet.
A very hard time started for the Nürburgring.
As the adulation fades, the emptiness encourages a new kind of fame and tenant.
A few manufacturers always knew about the testing possibilities on the Nordschleifer and the effect it had on developing the road holding of the car.
Since the ring's inception, the German auto industry has used it to test their engines. However, by the 70s, a seismic shift takes place in the car world. Automakers see a new market for high-performance machines. Factory-modified race-bred cars built for the street.
The M brand started off in 1972. It's a nice play with numbers because the Nürburgring itself was founded in 1927. So the two and the seven just swap places, and that's the beginning of M.
To perfect the dual personalities of these new machines, engineers need the repeatability of a racetrack and the unpredictability of a public street. The Nordschleifer offers both.
If you do a testing round, you can't get every condition there is in real life doing just one turn on the Nürburgring track, and that makes it so very, very special.
Engineers flock to the ring. The explosion in testing transforms the area.
Since in the 1980s, many car makers used the Nürburgring for their professional car testing. This also attracted suppliers. So there was a little automobile industry growing around the Nürburgring.
By the end of the 80s, there are so many prototypes running on the ring that the circuit needs a new set of rules.
Then special dedicated test time, which was blocked only for industrial tests, started at the end of the 80s.
For 16 weeks a year, the car industry is the primary user and benefactor of the ring.
There are only 16 industry exclusive weeks during the year, which start in March and it ends in October. So you roughly have 2 weeks per month that we can test the cars.
The ring remains a relative secret for the rest of the 80s and early 90s.
In the early days, nobody knew the place. It was just a few locals.
What starts as a hotbed for German engineers soon becomes an international destination.
It is not a coincidence that all the manufacturers from the United States, from Japan, from Korea, and of course all the Europeans, they all test their products here.
The combination of 73 corners and over 300 meters of dynamic elevation changes is perfect for proving new machines, new parts, and especially new transmissions. Inside the Namyang R&D Center, engineers design a manual transmission.
For the first time in Hyundai Motors, we have started to develop manual transmission for high-performance cars.
They shift over 500,000 times to ensure that the gearbox can withstand the rigors of the ring.
Typically, the tests take 1.5 months or 2 months.
Guaranteeing everyday durability is important, but it's absolutely crucial to withstand the Nürburgring.
If the transmission boxes pass the criteria standards, they will be installed into actual cars.
As one team continues to develop the transmission, another group focuses on getting the drivetrain's power to the ground. They test a new electronic limited slip differential. When a driver takes a sharp turn and a tire loses traction, the unit reroutes power to the other wheel to ensure maximum performance.
The tests show the stability of cars that went through under swift cornering conditions.
The electronic limited slip differential is one of the critical technologies needed for high-performance wet weather driving, something that's all too common on the ring. Once the latest ELSD and transmission units are installed, it's time to ship the prototype over 8,000 kilometers to the Nürburgring Nordschleife, where it will be put through its paces, lap after brutal lap. The Nürburgring has been hallowed automotive ground for nearly 100 years. But the last 20 may be its most important. A who's who of the auto world have set up shop just a stone's throw away from the ring.
It is well known Nürburgring is the toughest track in the world.
To become a household high-performance name, Hyundai must tackle the ring with their new prototype.
It's delivered in a prototype stage. All the systems are working. We then put in the sensor and measurement equipment and set the car up for the test.
At the Nürburgring R&D Center, the team wires each new prototype machine with a variety of computer sensors that monitor a wide range of functions such as engine, transmission, and braking performance. Once the car is prepped and wired, it's time to hit the track.
With these tests, we want to learn if the vehicle and vehicle systems work as designed.
Test pilots will drive over 480 accelerated durability laps in every conceivable weather condition.
Our 10,000-kilometer Nürburgring Nordschleifen endurance test is equivalent to about 150,000 to 180,000 kilometers driving on the regular streets.
Machines are tested at 90% of their maximum performance. The goal is to collect as much data as possible.
With a high-performance vehicle, we will really get to the limit of physics.
Being tested at the Nürburgring is a stamp of approval. This single location has defined an entire generation of cars and shaped the future of the automobile.
We also have some outside consultants who are working and driving on the Nürburgring for decades. So they know every little curbstone and every tree in the Eifel Forest.
One of those consultants is Dirk Scheussmann, a longtime Nürburgring test pilot with over 1 million kilometers of prototype experience.
Professional drivers like Dirk, he can drive fast without risking too much. This comes from years of experience.
You might not have heard Dirk's name, but you've certainly seen the cars he's worked on.
People, they want to race you, and that is simply stupid, yeah? It is not a race, yeah? Almost at the end of the straight. So you have a 2.8 kilometer straight, so that means the most cars, they reach their top speed here, just before the bridge. So this kink is really full speed, yeah? Then you look up the chicane, so we know everything is clear. You will notice many, many bumps and things. The car is moving a lot, yeah?
Professional test pilots aren't just fast. They have an uncanny ability to feel the car.
So now we get to a very nice area where fast cars get a little bit airborne here on the hump. You feel how the car is a bit lighter. On this section we see the highest temperatures of the transmission, for example.
The Nordschleifer's 73 corners punish almost every component on a car, making it the perfect venue to prove new technologies.
The past decades, we introduced ceramic brakes, we introduced double clutch gearbox. All these gadgets, ideas, of course, were tested on the Nürburgring and then transferred into serial production.
The key to testing is when a pilot returns. Both man and machine must be downloaded.
When the test driver comes back from test, then I will do a debriefing, and he will tell me if there is some problem on the car. We will download the data from the vehicle data logger, which recorded all the data of all systems.
Next, engineers send the information back to their colleagues inside the Namyang R&D Center.
Due to the 7 to 8 hour differences between our research centers, one side of the world works while the other rests.
The work never stops. It's a round-the-clock quest to push the brand into new territory.
We'll then get some modified parts or modified software. We'll test these solutions on the track.
By the time the team wakes, data isn't the only thing that's been inspected. Each day, the Nürburgring operations team surveys the asphalt at dawn.
When we open in the morning, they go on the test lab, check the track, if everything is fine. So when the track is clear, it will be open for testing, for racing, for the tourist cars.
The staff keep an eye on all 20.8 kilometers from inside a high-tech control room.
If a crash happens, the track will be closed. The safety team will go out and check what happened. If necessary, the ambulance will be called. We check if everything is okay, and then the track will be reopened.
Keeping the track open is vital because it's a mecca for car fans from around the world.
It's like a magnet for petrol heads.
Some visitors hire professional drivers. Perhaps the most famous is Sabine Schmitz, affectionately known as the Queen of the Ring.
My record is 1,250 laps in 1 year. I was always driving very spectacular, sideways, with one hand, waving to spectators, having fun.
Sabine's career starts thanks to some youthful delinquency.
The first time I was on the ring myself was in my mom's car. I had no driver license, nothing. I just took her car and I went up to the ring. as fast as I could go, I disappeared on the track. Really big, big fun. The only thing was my mom was a bit confused. Where are my tires gone? No brakes on the car.
During a taxi drive, ordinary people can hire professional pilots to take them on a fast lap around the track.
Never been in a race car before, so it's very exciting. I've dreamt of this since I was a little boy, so.
For some, that fantasy begins in the virtual world.
I probably have 1,000 laps on this track in Forza.
Forza is one of a handful of video games that has ignited a passion for the ring in the next generation.
All these simulation racing games give the opportunity to learn the Nordschleife. And it's pretty cool that even the young people, the kids, know the Nordschleife.
Video games aren't just for kids. They play an important role for pro drivers too.
What I learned from a lot of race drivers is they just played, and then when they came, of course, they knew the track.
The representation is nearly photorealistic, but nothing beats the ring in real life.
The best thing I've ever done. Better than sex.
Being a passenger is one thing. Sliding behind the wheel is another. The Nordschleife is actually a public road. The circuit is only closed during races or testing events.
People can come with their own car and drive on the Nürburgring for approximately 27 euros per lap.
We have recreational tourism here, so people are here to have fun. Here it's completely open. Everybody can have a go. Whatever car they have, it's like Wild West.
Ordinary people can try the ring during tourist drives.
The first lap is quite an experience you will never forget in your whole life.
In recent years, smaller companies established a rental business right here at the track.
Trackside rentals come prepped with roll cages and extra safety systems.
You have to make sure you keep on the right side of the track. You can only overtake on the left side. If you see someone waving yellow flag or you see a yellow light flash, and that means there has been an accident.
Accidents here have severe consequences.
If you have an accident and you are guilty because it's your fault, then you have to pay.
Crash and you're not only liable for damages, but also the track's lost revenue. 1 hour of downtime can cost over 1,300 euros. And that doesn't even include the ambulance and tow truck fees. There are so many visitors racing that it's spurred a new cottage industry.
I'm here to film. Most people think it's all about crashes, but that's just a small part. We film here the entire day.
The most popular videos feature multiple crashes, but some show a more outlandish side for the circuit.
You can have an old Suburban, an old limousine. I've seen a BMW with bikes on its roof. The craziest things I've seen here are obviously the DHL van.
Expedited overnight delivery service is fast, but at the Nordschleife, true speed isn't measured in days or hours, but seconds. The Nürburgring Nordschleife has always been about speed. Early on, purpose-built race cars dominate. But by the end of the century, the competition shifts gears.
There is horsepower, there's acceleration, there's top speed, but there's also the Nordschleife lap time.
A select few super sport manufacturers start promoting the lap times of their newest street legal machines.
The Nürburgring lap time is the ultimate proof for a sports car. You cannot fake it, you have to do it.
a fully-fledged automotive arms race develops. Only instead of car versus car, it's now car versus clock. The goal is simple: to be known as the fastest manufacturer to lap the ring.
The Nürburgring is the thing right now, and you have to put up a lap time when you introduce a new supercar or sports car. It really became a performance measurement.
Soon brands realized that a fast lap pays off in other ways.
A car manufacturer who launches a new model which laps under 7 minutes, for example, must be a good car. And that, at the end, pays off on the marketing side.
On the morning of September the 4th, 2013, Porsche sets the standard when they take their 918 Spyder to the ring.
When I came around the last corner and I saw the 657, it was a good feeling. It was great. It was good to see the numbers up there.
When the 918 crosses the line, it becomes the fastest production car to ever lap the ring. However, success at the Nürburgring is often fleeting. Just 3 months later, the McLaren P1 breaks the 7-minute mark as well, putting the world on notice that automotive advancement never stops.
Can you master the Nürburgring? I say, no, you can't. Yeah? You can try, but you will never succeed permanently. Maybe that's also a part of the mystique or the myth of the Nürburgring and the green hell.
Not that long ago, brands like Porsche and McLaren were plucky newcomers, battling to be recognized. Today, they're household high-performance names. While they fight to stay on top, others battle to break in and make their mark in the automotive world.
We have defined the character of our first high-performance car, and now the car team is serving this character.
If there's one truism in the car industry, it's to never underestimate an upstart.
It started like all little startups in a garage, with four vehicles being prepared there and serviced there.
The passion that starts in a small garage continues.
Our designing and testing team members work late at night, even though I urge them to go home.
Together, the new machines and the motor company are taking their first steps towards one day setting records of their own. Some might very well be set on the Nürburgring Nordschleife. The longest, fastest, and most challenging track in the world.
If you build a racetrack today, I think the Nordschleife is just a perfect example of how a racetrack should be.
The Nürburgring is a treasure not only for Germany, but for everybody who loves cars.